disclaimer for the viewers. In this session, we are going to discuss the evaluation of transdermal drug delivery system and characterization of the transdermal patches. So let us see the evaluation and characterization of the transdermal drug delivery systems. Transdermal drug delivery system, it is evaluated for the physicochemical parameters. It is evaluated with respect to in vitro test and the in vivo test. In the case of physicochemical test, we are going to evaluate the transdermal product with respect to the compatibility study, then the thickness of the patch, then uniformity of weight, drug content, moisture content, adhesiveness evaluation, then tensile strength of patch, folding endurance, water vapor transmission studies, and the microscopic studies. In vitro study, we are going to discuss the in vitro release, then in vitro permeation, and the stability studies. And in vivo studies, that is by using the animal models, by using the human volunteers, and the toxicological evaluation of the transdermal patch. So in the case of evaluation of transdermal drug delivery system, it is evaluated with respect to the physicochemical test, that is the compatibility study. Compatibility study, it is performed for the excipients, that is the whatever the polymer which is used in the transdermal patch and the drug. So here we have to suppose to perform the compatibility of the drug with respect to the other excipients present in it. Then the thickness test. Thickness of the patch, it should be measured by using the suitable equipment. Then the uniformity of weight. The weight, it is possible to measure by using the balance. Then the drug content. Drug content should be determined with the help of suitable instruments, that is the UV visible spectrophotometer. Then the moisture content, maybe with the help of desiccator, it is possible to get the idea about the moisture content which is present in the patch, which will help us to give the idea about the stability of the API, stability of the product. Then adhesiveness evaluation. Yes, as transdermal patch, it is applied to the skin. There is a need to evaluate the adhesive property of the transdermal patch. Then the tensile strength. Yes, there is a need to measure the tensile strength of the transdermal patch, because if it is not having a sufficient mechanical strength, it is not going to be retained onto the skin. Then the folding endurance. Again, this is one of the tests which gives the idea about the mechanical properties of the patch. Then water vapor transmission studies and the microscopic studies. So these tests we are going to study under the physicochemical tests. Then in vitro studies. In vitro studies, we are going to see the details of in vitro drug release. How the drug it is going to be released from the transdermal patch. Then in vitro permeation studies and the stability studies according to ICH guidelines. Then in vivo evaluation of patch by using the animal models, by using the healthy human volunteers, and the toxicological evaluation of the transdermal patch. So let us see the few details about the all these tests. So very first test, that is the compatibility study. It is commonly carried out using the thermal analysis, that is the by using the DSE, then FTIR, that is Fourier transform infrared spectroscopy, UV and chromatographic technique, by comparing their physicochemical characters such as assay, melting endotherms, then characteristic wave numbers and absorption maxima, in order to get the idea about compatibility of drug with the other excipients used in the transdermal patch. So this is about the compatibility study. Then the thickness. Yes, thickness of patch needs to be measured. The patch should have the uniform thickness, or otherwise there may be the variation in the weight as well as the drug content. It is measured by using the traveling microscope, then dial screw gauge and the digital micrometer. So for the measurement of thickness, we are using the traveling microscope, dial or screw gauge, or the digital micrometer. Generally, the digital micrometer, it is widely used to measure the thickness of transdermal patch. As I have said that thickness of the patch, it is very important. It should be uniform. If there is a variation in the thickness, we will get the variation in the weight as well as the drug content. So whatever the manufacturing technique it is used, it needs to be optimized if we are getting the variation in the thickness of the patch. Then uniformity of weight. Uniformity of weight, it is one of the important parameter. If there is a variation in the uniformity of weight, we are getting the variation in the drug content also, and that may vary the dose. It is measured by using the digital balance. Whatever the patches are there, we have to measure individually the weight of each patch and determine the standard deviation, which will give us the idea about the uniformity of weight. Generally, the digital balance, it is used to measure the weight of the transdermal patches. Then the drug content. Drug content, it is important, as which will ensure the required quantity of drug in the transdermal patch or in the formulation. So here we have to suppose to use the suitable validated analytical method. For example, UV spectrophotometry or high performance liquid chromatography. Furthermore, it is possible to use the GC, GCMS and so on for the measurement of drug content from the transdermal patch. Then folding endurance. Well, folding endurance gives us the idea about mechanical properties of the transdermal patches. So it is repeatedly folding the patch at the same point until it breaks. So what we have to do, we have to suppose to take the patch and fold repeatedly at the same point. And the number of time it could be folded, it is its folding endurance value until it breaks. So folding endurance, in this test, we have to repeatedly fold the patch at the same point until it breaks. The number of time it could be folded is its folding endurance value. Generally, it should be more than 150. It will give us the idea about mechanical properties of the transdermal patch. Then the moisture content. Moisture content, it is one of the important parameter in the physicochemical evaluation, because which will decide the stability of the API from the transdermal patch. So here in the case of moisture content, film weighed individually. So we have to suppose to take the weight of the patch individually and are kept in a desiccator. So here we are using the desiccator. Might be all of you are aware about the use of desiccator containing fused calcium chloride at a room temperature for 24 hours. So we have to suppose to take the weight of patch and place this patch into the desiccator containing the fused calcium chloride at a room temperature for 24 hours. After 24 hours, films are to be re-weighed to determine the percent moisture content. So whatever the moisture present in the patch, it is being absorbed by the fused calcium chloride, isn't it? So before and after weight, we have to suppose to consider for the determination of moisture content. So the moisture content can be calculated by using the formula: percent moisture is equal to initial weight minus final weight into 100 divided by the final weight of the patch. So which will give us the idea about the percent moisture content. Let us move further. The next evaluation parameter, that is a microscopic study. Yes, here we are preparing the transdermal patches, and there is a need to see the surface properties of the transdermal patches, and which can be observed by using the Motic microscope and scanning electron microscopy. So these are the two equipments or the instrument which will give us the idea about the surface properties of the transdermal patch. Then percent moisture uptake. Again, it is one of the important thing, because we are exposing the transdermal patch to the environment after application. So how much amount of moisture it is going to be absorbed, that needs to be calculated in order to ensure the stability of the patch. So here, in the case of a percent moisture uptake, the wet films are to be kept in a desiccator at a room temperature for 24 hours, which contains a saturated solution of potassium chloride in order to maintain 84% of relative humidity. We are exposing the transdermal patch to the relative humidity of 84%. And after 24 hours, the films are to be re-weighed to determine the percent moisture uptake from the formula. So here, the percent moisture uptake can be calculated by using the formula. Percent moisture uptake is equal to final weight minus initial weight into 100 divided by the initial weight. So this is about the percent moisture uptake. Let us see the water vapor permeability. Water vapor permeability can be determined with the foam dressing method. So here we are using the foam dressing method to determine the water vapor permeability, wherein the air forced oven is replaced by a natural air circulation oven. The water vapor permeability can be determined by using the formula, that is, the water vapor permeability is equal to W by A. Here, the water vapor permeability is expressed in gram per meter square per 24 hour, where the W is the amount of vapor permeated through the patch, expressed in a gram per 24 hour, and A is the surface area of exposed sample expressed in meter square. So this is about the water vapor permeability. Let us move. Swelling studies. Yes, here we are using the so many types of the polymer, and maybe the polymers are swellable one. So in such cases, there is a need to perform the swelling study. Generally, we are using the suitable solvent, suitable phosphate buffer for the swelling studies. And furthermore, we are determining, or it is possible to determine the percent swelling by using the formula. That is, percent swelling is equal to weight after swelling minus initial weight into 100 divided by the initial weight. So this formula will give us the idea about swelling of the transdermal patch. Then the surface pH. Surface pH of the transdermal patch, it is an important thing. As you know that the skin, it is having a certain pH, and the transdermal patch should have the same pH near to skin, or otherwise we will get the irritation. So in order to ensure that, there is a need to measure the surface pH of the transdermal patch, and it should be measured by using the suitable pH meter. It should be validated. Then physical appearance of patch. Designed and developed patch visually inspected for the color, clarity, flexibility, and the smoothness. Then tensile strength of patch, it should be determined by using the tensile strength apparatus, which will give us the idea about mechanical properties of the transdermal patch. Then let us see the evaluation of adhesive. As the transdermal patch, it is applied to the skin with the help of the adhesive. So there is a need to evaluate the adhesive property of the transdermal patch. There are various tests are there which can be utilized to analyze the adhesives from the transdermal patch. That is very first one, that is the peel adhesion properties, then tack properties and shear strength. In the case of tack properties, there are again four tests are there. That is thumb tack test, rolling ball test, then quick stick or peel tack test and probe tack test. So let us see one by one the each test for the evaluation of adhesives. Very first test, that is the peel adhesion test. In the case of peel adhesion test, here we are determining the force required to remove an adhesive coating. So in the case of peel adhesion test, we are determining the force required to remove an adhesive coating. So this is the apparatus which comprises, this is the standard panel or the substrate. Here it's a backing film and this one is the adhesive ream, isn't it? We have to suppose to pull this at a 180 degree, right? So this is about the peel adhesion test. Then the tack properties, very first test, that is the thumb tack test. Here the force required to remove the thumb from adhesive is a measure of tack. Simply, here we are using the thumb in order to get the idea about the adhesive property of the transdermal patch. So in the case of thumb tack test, the force required to remove the thumb from the adhesive is a measure of tack. The second test, that is the rolling ball test. So in the case of rolling ball test, it measures the softness of the polymer. So this is the rolling ball test apparatus. Here this is the slope, or that is the, which is having a angle of 22.5 degree. So this is the slope which is a 22.5 degree, and here 7 by 16 ball. Then here it's a backing layer and this is the adhesive film. So in the case of rolling ball test, it measures the softness of the polymer. The next test, that is the peel tack test or the quick stick test. So in the peel tack test, the force required to break bond between adhesive and substrate, it is measured. So this is the equipment which is used for the peel tack test. So this is, here it's a stainless steel plate. This is the backing membrane or backing layer, and this is the adhesive film, isn't it? So in the case of a quick stick test, we are measuring the force required to break the bond between the adhesive and the substrate. Then the probe tack test. In the case of probe tack test, the force required to pull the probe away from the adhesive at a fixed rate, it is recorded as a tack and it is expressed in the gram. So this is the equipment which is widely used for the probe tack test. So which consists of, this is the angular weight, right? So here you can see the angular weight, then this is the force gauge, this is the probe, this is the adhesive film, and this is the backing layer. So in the case of probe tack test, the force required to pull the probe away from the adhesive at a fixed rate is recorded as a tack and it is expressed in grams. Then the last test, that is the shear strength properties. It is the measure of cohesive strength. This is the apparatus which is used for the measurement of shear strength properties. Here it's a stainless steel plate, then this is a adhesive coated tape, and here it's weight. So this is about the adhesive tests which are used to evaluate the transdermal patches. Let us move further towards the in vitro tests. Let us see the in vitro evaluation of transdermal patches. There are three tests are there. Very first one, in vitro release studies. Second one, that is in vitro permeation studies. And third one, that is a stability studies. The in vitro release studies comprises the dissolution studies of the transdermal patches by using paddle over disc method, that is the USP5 apparatus, and the cylinder modified USP basket, that is USP 6 apparatus. So these are the apparatus which are widely used for the in vitro release studies of the transdermal patches. Then in vitro permeation studies, generally we are using the Franz diffusion cell or the Kayser chain diffusion cell and the flow through diffusion cell. Then the stability studies, we have to suppose to perform the stability studies of the developed transdermal patch according to ICH guidelines. So this is about the in vitro evaluation test for the transdermal patches. Let us move further. The in vivo evaluation. In the in vivo evaluation, generally we are using the animal models or the human volunteers. Here in the case of animal models, generally the mouse, hairless rat, hairless dog, hairless rhesus monkey, then rabbit, guinea pigs are widely used. And in the human volunteer, generally measuring the radioactivity in a excreta following topical application of the labeled drug. We have to suppose to apply the transdermal patch which may contain radio labeled compound, and furthermore we have to suppose to get the idea about the radioactivity. It is to be measured. So in the vivo evaluation, generally we are using the animals like mouse, hairless rats, dogs, then monkey, rabbit, guinea pig, and human volunteers are also used for the in vivo evaluation. Then toxicological evaluation of transdermal patches, it is also done by using the animal models with respect to contact dermatitis and the furthermore the growth of microorganisms. So in the case of contact dermatitis, it is there are few tests are there, that is a contact irritant dermatitis or 10 or 21 days irritation test, then laser Doppler, then evaporative water loss measurement, and contact allergic dermatitis. Here in the case of contact dermatitis, it is possible to use the animal models as well as the human volunteers. Then the growth of microorganisms, it needs to be studied because furthermore it is going to affect the or produce the certain superficial infections to the skin, isn't it? So there are two tests are there, that is a localized superficial infections and the prickly heat. By using suitable method, we have to suppose to measure the growth of microorganisms. So this is about the in vitro evaluation, in vivo evaluation, and the toxicological evaluation of the transdermal drug delivery system. So herewith we have finished the evaluation of transdermal drug delivery system. We have discussed the compatibility study, thickness, uniformity of weight, drug content, moisture content, adhesive evaluation, tensile strength, holding endurance, water vapor transmission studies, and the microscopic studies in the physicochemical test. In vitro test, we have seen the in vitro release, then in vitro permeation, and the stability studies. And in vivo, that is the animal models, human volunteers, and the toxicological evaluation. So this is about the evaluation of transdermal drug delivery system.